Hi, good afternoon. This is Chris DC, and again, welcome back to my channel. I know I'm not uploading any video for the past month now, kasi minsan wala naman ako maisip what will I share here in this community and YouTube. I decided to share with you how I get here in Dubai. So, 2008 nang pumunta ako dito ng Dubai, and then I have a relative who are working here as a housemaid, but she is so lucky because her employee are very nice to her. So to make it short story, she is the one who helping me to come here in Dubai. So I sent all the document. I think I remember only passport that time and the money. So the money I sent was 40,000 pesos, if I remember. Then for 1 week I get the visit visa, which is so quick. So after that I had to flew in Dubai for a week, so it's very difficult for me to leave my kids, but I have no choice. I have 1.5 years old, I have 2.5, and the eldest is 4. That time my youngest is I'm giving breastfeed. So my flight is like morning, like 8 o'clock. My flight is 8 o'clock in the morning. That is the last breastfeed that he have. I don't know what's going on the next few hours, but what I am thinking that I'm doing all this for them because I have no choice. That time me and my husband are jobless, so I couldn't do anything just to go with the flow. So this is the opportunity, open opportunity for me, even though I don't know what will happen to me that time to come here in Dubai. But you know, life has to be positive, and you have to be focused what plans will gonna work for you. So that time I decided to go here and leave my family. So that's the story. When I was in the airport, she said to me that where is the signature of the sponsor. So I said to her that that's only I have in my documents. So she said to me that no, you cannot go to Dubai because you don't have this document. So I was so shocked during the time, because the one who bring me in the airport is she left already. She's my sister-in-law. So how could I go back in my place now? Of course I had to go by taxi, but the point is they are expecting that I'm going to Dubai. So that time I'm like, I will go back to my home and reprocess the document again. So there is one policeman who approached me and said to me, "Kabayan, what anong nangyari?" Sabi niya, "Kabayan, anong nangyari? Kabayan, what's happened?" He said to me, I said that they refused me to pass because my sponsor didn't happen to sign in his passport at the back. So I think that is also very important because that matched to my documents with her. I cannot blame them that time. But there is one guy who helping me that if you want, I will accompany you. Just give me some if you have, you know, just for the boys. I said, okay, what happens to me is I give him whatever I have. That time I just have like $100, if I remember, 100 plus, because my brother gave me that time. So what left to me is like 100 dirhams, like 1,000 pesos in my pocket. So I didn't think about that. I was just thinking just to pass to that immigration and get in the plane and go to Dubai. That's what I'm thinking. So I put in the tissue and I gave it to him, and he accompanied me to pass the line. So I am very relieved that time, because I couldn't imagine what happens to me if I didn't pass to that immigration, but one thing is why they have to do that. They should understand that the document is all there, and the supporting document is all there, but only the signature, for sure that signature would be matched to her tag mark. So I don't know, it's just that happened to me. And then when I passed, I have like I have to go to Hong Kong because my flight is not direct, so I am standby in Hong Kong like 3 hours. Then I go here in Dubai. She is the one who also picked me up in the airport. I was so thankful to her because I don't know where I am without her here. So that's my story here in Dubai. Then I am like how many days staying here, and then the one who sponsored me took me from her and bring me to her house because I was not able to stay longer in her place because she's living with her employer, so maybe they don't want me to stay there. So the one who sponsored me, she have a Pakistani husband, and they are very generous and kind. I even eat that time to their place, and it's free. So that time I don't know where to go. I don't know what will happen. And there is one Filipina who live with them. She said to me, I have no one person that help you. Thank you for watching, and next time we will talk about how I get my job and how to go to Dubai as a visit visa.